Hey there, if you want to know how to keep spam from your inbox on email, I've got just the thing for you. Come on, let's get started. Hi, this is Sine, and I want to bring you a short video on a tool that I use that helps me keep my email inbox completely free and clear of spam. The only thing that makes it through to my inbox are the emails that I want. So I use a program called Mailwasher. Mailwasher has a very unique characteristic in that it will check the mail and it will categorize, it will learn over time what I like and what I don't like. If other people mark it spam or if it's been blacklisted, Mailwasher knows that, it records that, and it marks it as well. Those things that I've said are things that I want. I've marked them as friends. They're highlighted one color. Those that I might want based on previous activity are marked green or good, but I have the choice of changing classification, if you will. So I'm able to view like the opening few lines, and I just spend a little time each day checking email and then classifying it like this. And then once I've classified it, I clicked wash mail. And then the only thing that comes into my email client are the emails that I've agreed that I want. So let's open that again and let's look at that. So let's check mail one more time, make sure we've got the latest, greatest copy of everything that's out there. And I have multiple email accounts, so I have multiple servers as a result. So this one, website rank on Google, no, I'm thinking this is probably not something I want. I didn't ask for this. They have just sent this to me randomly. So I'm going to mark this as spam, and I'm going to go one step further. I'm going to bounce this account. In other words, they're going to get an email back from my server saying my email address doesn't exist. Well, guess what that does? That updates their list, because a lot of these people are automated. That updates their list and says to them, I'm not a real email address, so I automatically am removed from their list. And that's what you want. Okay. Next, creating a course on edX. Well, actually, this happens to be one I do want, because I've been involved in the edX Studio literature. I've been trying to teach myself how to create content on the edX Studio platform. So this is something I am interested in. So I would right-click and then say Add Sender to Friends List. Now, in the future, anything that comes in from this email address will automatically be marked as a friend. So when I just click wash mail, they'll never be deleted because they're a friend. This is also a group that I belong to. I'm happy to leave that coming in. This, however, is not one. I did not ask for this information. I haven't surfed anywhere where this information might be applicable to me. So I am going to mark this as add sender to blacklist. This means that I'm saying this person is a spammer so that others might agree with me. I'm going to go one step further and I'm going to bounce. I'm going to press the letter B to bounce this account. Again, these people are going to be told my email address doesn't exist as a result. Last but not least is an email that I do have coming in that I am a subscriber for and is information that I am interested in. So I'm going to click wash mail, and what I'm going to wind up with are the three emails I agree I want. By clicking on that and clicking wash mail, now you'll notice right down here it is bouncing those two emails I told it to bounce. When that completes, and it does take a couple of moments, but when that completes, my email program will open automatically and I'll be able to click go get mail without worrying about all the crap that spammers send, and I'm not going to have to delete that or remove that. So my inbox stays as clear as possible and without all the crap I don't want. So click get messages and we'll see that I just have those few messages that I agreed should come in. Now, I do use Thunderbird, and watch for an upcoming video on how to install that and set that up for your multiple email accounts. A lot of my accounts are webmails, and Thunderbird allows me to bring them all into one platform. So I hope this video has helped. This is Mailwasher Pro, and click the link down below to see how you can get your own copy. This is Sine signing out. Happy interneting.